like to say that first, oh, there you are. First of all, because Glenn's book is in with my book, with my agent publisher, I wanted Henry to start off with a poem of Glenn's from his book, I Am Keats, As You Are. And some of you will remember this poem, and others this will be new to you, and you can just take it from there, Henry.
All right,
Henry.
The pressure is on. Oh, stand up.
Where's the microphone?
I can speak loud.
It's not an addition, though, Henry.
Of importance, August 12th, 2009. The other day, actually it was this evening, I realized that I am terribly important. Terrifically important, honestly, just like you and all the others. I was watching an old episode of The West Wing, nobly principled president of my perfect dream, making my mind expansive, bigger than life. There he stood, kindling re-election at some military base in Indiana, rousing my moral idealism and fictional patriotism while a massive flag hovered, unfurled in the background. And suddenly it dawned on me. All those past invitations and conclaves made retrospective sense because of my newly realized importance. My meeting with the Prime Minister and all others, and with the President and various dictators. My meeting some years ago with the Pope at a lovely little cafe in Florence. The Archbishop with tea, and after the hours passed, some scotch slowly slipped. And all the various cardinals and bishops and deacons over many years. The Dalai Lama called some years ago. He is a voice-to-voice kind of man, but the date he proposed conflicted with my appointment with Nelson Mandela, which was to be winning-free at his weekend retreat outside Johannesburg. So Mandela won out over any Mandela at the time, and the Dalai Lama and I could never sync our calendars. Letterman called once, yes, he himself, and then begged off as a wrong number when he found out that I was Canadian. Something about a quota met. But I think he and Paul may have been having a rough phase at the time. Oprah's team called twice, but the conditions were strange, and perhaps my importance was intimidating her. Too mono a mono. Various think tanks and intellectuals and celebrities have called me for advice, sometimes well under the radar, which is fine. I've never been attracted to the publicity, but it is finally nice to understand why all the summons and summits through my ears, the sheer importance of me, well, and you, and all the others, of course. The intellectuals have always have terribly specific questions, inquiries, which make for effective, efficient conversation. And given the way my mind works, it is important, its importance, you know, giving to quick and clear answers. John Keynes in some macroeconomic, Vaclav Havel in something poetically political, Stephen Hawking in some space-time think, Barack Obama with a specific satirical subject, Vladimir Horowitz with a question of fingering pattern, and Alex Trebek with some incidents of great jeopardy. Make no mistake, there have been a great women as well. Mother Teresa with a quiet matter. Katharine Hepburn with some fascinating questions about blocking. Yoko Ono with many questions of why. Angela Lawson with many questions that I couldn't answer or deemed wise not to do so. Jackie Kay really just for a chat. And Anne Hathaway, well, actually, I phoned her. Of course, part of being important is an inflationary sense of self, which goes well beyond the magnitude of one's actual importance. I was just discussing with Jimmy Carter the other day, or was it Bono? Anyway, when you deflate the falsely inflated part of yourself, all the heated, expansive importance, you are left shockingly with your real self. So sadly, I and all the dignitaries and luminaries that I've referenced are under the skin a bit, rubber, a balloon, bald skin, are just the same in terms of importance. Ego be damned. The human condition calls us to sameness and humility when stripped past our skin, all its rubbery layers, some thick, some thin, down to the basics, naked, wasted, fragile, we're all the same creature. Further DNA evidence, but enough proving in our humble existences, if we allow ourselves the luxury of in truth selfless examination, flesh and bone, mind and soul basics. Though I must say the importance was nice while it lasted, and all the meetings, caucuses, political and religious trysts were, well, exciting, in hindsight, and quite terribly important.